happens with me, when I do what I'm doing, but I'm doing it like I'm doing it for TV.
I guess you can get away with this stuff if you can punch like Hamed. The British love eccentrics, and they sure have produced one.
Naseem Hamed finally enters the ring with a record of 32 wins, no losses, no draws, 29 KOs, 12 knockouts in title fight. The only fighter who was able to go the distance against Naz in a title fight is the guy you saw go the distance with Eric Morales a few moments ago, Wayne McCullough of Ireland. While you're watching this upcoming bout, you can also log on to www.hbo.com/boxing to chat and score each round of tonight's action. While you're logged onto our website, we welcome you to voice your opinion on the poll question for the evening. Does it matter to you, one way or another, that Prince Naseem Hamed does not hold one of the three most recognized championship belts? Does it diminish him that he holds an off-brand belt? Respond yes or no, and we'll provide you with results later in this telecast. And now let's go up to ring announcer Michael Buffer to kick it off.
And Cedric Kushner Promotions and Prince Promotions Incorporated. Assalamu alaikum. Along with your undisputed, undefeated king of beers, Budweiser. Proud to be your bud. In association with Top Rank Incorporated, present champion versus champion. 12 rounds of boxing for the featherweight championship of the world. Sanctioned by the State of Michigan Boxing Commission, along with the WBC and the WBO. Michigan Commission Chairman David Sebastian, physicians at ringside, Dr. Ralph Sachs, Dr. Evan Ferris, timekeeper and counting for the knockdowns, Joe Collins and Dale Kalinowski. WBC President Jose Suleiman, WBC Supervisor at ringside Steve Crossan, WBO President Francisco Paco Barcarcel, and WBO Supervisor Gordy Volkman. The three judges scoring this bout on a 10-point must system will be Dario Ciarini, Mike Liena, and Chuck Hassett. And when the bell rings, your referee in charge of the action, Dale Grable. And now for the thousands in attendance and the millions watching around the world, from the Joe Louis Arena, Detroit, Michigan, ladies and gentlemen, let's get ready to rumble! Introducing first, fighting out of the red corner, wearing black with leopard trim. He weighs 126 pounds, and he brings a perfect professional record to the ring consisting of 32 bouts, 32 victories, including 29 by knockout. With two world title belts, he is considered by many to be, pound for pound, among the best in the world. Ladies and gentlemen, from Sheffield, England, presenting the reigning and defending undefeated WBO featherweight champion of the world, Prince Naseem Hamed. And his opponent across the ring, fighting out of the blue corner, wearing red, trimmed with gold letters, and weighing in also at 126 pounds. He has an outstanding professional record in 62 bouts. He has 53 victories, including 39 knockouts, with 7 defeats and 2 draws. Ladies and gentlemen, Damas y Caballeros de Juarez, Mexico, presenting the reigning and defending WBC featherweight champion of the world, Cesar Cobrita Soto.
Gentlemen, you're given your instructions in the dressing room. Listen to my commands at all times. Protect yourself at all times. Good luck to both of you. Touch them up.
When Soto was asked what would happen if the Prince hit him his best shot and Soto didn't blink, he said, "I feel sorry for him." That is the first thing we're looking for tonight. How can he handle the punch?
Meanwhile, a lot of people in the arena feel nothing but love for Prince Naseem. In case you weren't with us at the beginning of the telecast, the estimated Arab and Arab-related population of Greater Detroit is 275,000. The promoters believe that by fight time, it was quite possible more than half the people in the arena would be Arab. We have a startlingly large crowd, seemingly much more than two-thirds full. And no one expected that without an American fighter on the card. But Prince Naseem Hamed has his own unique appeal. And now round one begins.
What Soto has to do is just be basic. Don't get in caught up in the okey-doke trying to outshow this guy. After everything, get back into position. And the Prince has just got to be himself. You want a new trainer to add into your repertoire, but you don't want to drop anything you bring to the table.
Every fighter who faces Naz claims they'll be unruffled by the theatrics and they'll stay within their envelope. Not that easy to do once you are a part of the hoopla that surrounds the bout. You saw Naz come into the ring and go immediately over to Soto and touch gloves with him as if to say, "I hope you enjoyed my show."
Soto came out in this fight trying to rough Hamed up, as he's doing right now, but Hamed answered with that five-punch barrage about 20 seconds later, and now Soto has settled down a little bit.
And that's what's frightened me more about Hamed. Has he gone into training camp, lost some of what he brings to the table? Trainers have a way of just putting too much of their stamp into your style. Soto is solid, landed punches, gets back in position, ready to do it again.
Referee Dale Grable was trying to wrestle them apart as Hamed fired an uppercut right between Grable's arms.
Hamed is a counterpuncher. Feeds off of what you do. That's what you want to keep him doing. Boy, was power.
Not short, quick counter punches either, but long, looping counter punches thrown from odd angles and delivered with devastating power.
When he's off balance, he's the best there is. You give him some balance and you may have him just average.
Hard left hands by Hamed. And already Soto has that look on his face that seems to say, well, I'd heard he was a hard punter, but this is something new.
I think right now, really what's bothering Soto is the quickness of the Prince's punches rather than the power as yet. He's just beating him to the punch.
But Prince has that something about him.
Don't lock the,
he does two things to your left and then comes back to the right with a power shot. He hasn't demonstrated that tonight.
Naz
working to the right and then do something left.
Naz working to the body through part of this first round. Does not always deign to throw body punches, but seems to want to say to Soto, okay, I've heard you can punch to the ribcage. Watch this. And now Naz poses for a while before coming back to the corner to talk to Emmanuel Stewart.
Did you down something?
Yeah. Okay, sit down.
You're looking great shape. Let me tell you something.
See, you're shooting all of the big shots. As soon as you start, he's going up. He's going up. He's giving you where you don't get much either way. So I'm playing with him a little bit.
You got so much speed. Sooner or later, he's going to shoot one of them slow shots, and you want to catch him with a counter punch. But start getting the range. Just start playing with him. And once you get to studying,
did you see anything different? You have to get take advantage of this guy. When he jumps, go right to the chest.
Two. Go back. Go on.
You heard Emmanuel Stewart advising the Prince, be calm, let Soto throw punches and leave himself open for one of your quicker counter punches.
And he said, play with him. So I would like to applaud Emmanuel Stewart for putting that into it. Play with him. That's what he needs to hear. I didn't think Emmanuel would do that.
Well, Emmanuel says he's not trying to remake the Prince, simply hoping for some refinements in what he does. Noteworthily, Stewart says, I'd like to get him to at least pay a little attention to defending himself and not be so easy to hit.
Soto has now been warned twice, once for leading with his head and once for a rabbit punch.
Naz waiting for Soto to come in and firing the left uppercut. Soto trying to stay within a tight envelope and set up his left hook. Oh, and just missed with a big left hook there.
Oh, it didn't miss. It hurt him.
It flipped him.
It slapped him real good.
Yeah. Stop. Listen, when I say break, break.
Okay.
The Prince tries to use his dexterity and quickness to lean away from his opponents, and sometimes he gets clipped like that.
Soto just has to remain solid. Keep your left foot in front of you. Jab with your left. Throw your right in a straight fashion. If he does that, things can happen good for Soto.
Houses heavily for Hamed, but there are some Soto rooters here too. And you'll hear them whenever the Mexican star produces a rally.
Hamed has not been able to get into his rhythm tonight. He's trying so hard to be the aggressor.
Shot